This is Ronnie Giovanni telling you to join the Foul Mouth Owl Army. All you gotta do is ask your favorite venue owner to host the next Foul Mouth Owl show. It's great publicity and we can even bring the entertainment. Give them our number, 302-423-0276, or email us information to foulmouthowl@yahoo.com.
In this edition of the Foul Mouth Owl show, we have the payoff from our shot collar trivia game. The loser takes his licks and then gets a challenge from Ian, the producer, that he can take the shock longer. Then it gets a little more crazy as Ian, the producer, allows Salt to put the damn shock collar on a more sensitive part of the body. We all make fun of George Bush and some of the things he says in the book of quotes called Bushisms. Squiddy exposes his homosexual alter ego. This guy is a true split personality and needs medicine. If anyone wants to offer counseling for Squiddy Squid or anyone else on our staff, please contact foulmouthowl@yahoo.com. We may consider you for a regular panel position if you like. It all culminates in a hilarious conversation as the alcohol begins to kick in on Squid and Salt Relish.
All right, well, we're back. Hold on a second. Hold on, Ronnie Giovanni is all excited because he gets to put the shock collar on Salt Relish. And we all get to watch. It's got to do 10 seconds.
I can't do 10 seconds. I tested it out during the break. And
he did 2 seconds and he cried. He's fat.
All right.
All of his hair popped out like a big old snap. Right,
you got it? Hold him tight. Don't let go. If you let go, we're going to hold you down. You're going to start over.
No, I can't do this shit. It's going to hurt me.
Come on, man.
I might have a
Ian, hold him down.
Go ahead. Do it.
Look, a defibrillator. Fucking Mike, defibrillate me.
Ian knows CPR. Don't worry about it.
I do.
All right, ready? Go. Go now.
Hold on. Mikey. No.
Oh, you let go. No,
that hurt.
You gotta start over, dude.
No, I just did it. No,
that was 5 seconds, dude.
All right, five.
You got five more seconds.
I'm going to put 10 seconds on the clock. And then that way he could see the clock. Listen, is it on?
Yeah, go.
No. All right, it's on. I hear the beeper. Hold on, I'll give you the thing. Let me get my timer going.
Come on, bitch.
Relax, Mike. We haven't started yet.
I didn't use the tape.
Oh, okay.
Hold on. Let me get
it
10.
It went off on you.
Tested it.
No,
it just went off. I heard it. He just tested it.
No, that was good.
Let me get 10 seconds
activated
on the clock.
No, you don't want.
It's working.
No,
I just
shit
tested
hurts,
it,
man.
All right, here we go.
Here's... No, you had me enough already.
No, man.
Here we go. Tell me when to start, Salt.
Go.
All right, go. Hey, you hear that crunching? 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh. 8 seconds, man.
That's close enough. I did enough.
You owe us 2 seconds.
Here, do that shit again to this guy.
He had a default. 2 seconds already.
Damn, that shit hurts.
Here, Ian, you want to try it?
I'll do the last two seconds.
Yeah. Sweet. It's pretty nice.
See, Ian is
I got
good
one of them,
Ian,
too.
I'm still
Ian
two
is a good. Here, hand that to him.
You know what I do, Albert? I just put my fingers on both prongs and drag it, and that turns mine on. Mine's automatic.
Yeah.
So I don't have to be around him.
Yeah, so your dog, you just got it set
hold
up so it shocks
it
your dog.
It shocks him every
I'll
time he barks.
I'll definitely do two, and then I'll try to beat your record.
I'll try to beat my record.
Oh, wait a minute now. He's challenging.
I'm not saying I am. I'm probably going to let go after two.
Yeah, no, you're going
to
let up as soon as he hits you.
Salt had.
You ain't going to expect it.
Everybody see Salt had 8.9.
No, he didn't.
You're not going to expect it.
Yeah, 9.5. Oh, really?
8.9 seconds. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Grab
wait, let me.
You gonna go for the record first?
I'll try. No, I'm going for the 2 seconds first.
Well, 2 seconds is
no,
easy.
Just go for the record.
Yeah, just go for the record. Just all see right how long you can hold it. Ready, set.
What?
It ain't hitting you.
Nope, it didn't beat. There.
All right, you gotta separate those wires, dude.
Oh yeah, he's touching.
Yeah.
It.
Oh
cheat
shit.
Just
oh
separate
yeah, you said pin. Wait, don't
just
do
separate
it
them
no,
a bit.
Mike, don't mess with that. It's on.
It's there on now.
It was on, Salt.
Oh.
You turned it off.
It was just blinking lock.
Salty really?
Oh my.
Salty really.
Alright, so here the buzzing. Are we ready? And here it is. Here it's going. Ian said 3 seconds. 4.
Yo, it's not even that bad right now.
5.
I'm used to it.
Ian's
now
liking
stop
it.
Move your fingers just a little bit while it's doing.
Why would you? Oh, that's nice. Like rolling a mustache. Oh, that's very nice. I like it. It's shocked
stick
from
it
this.
Stick it on here.
Ian likes it.
Nice.
Ian started liking it.
I think I'm used. I'm not. I used to take that.
I think you found a new addiction.
What, the shock pen?
Yeah, I know, he's doing it right now.
He's got a new addiction.
Yeah, but the shock pen's pretty much a vibration.
No, it's electric.
It is electric.
Yeah.
It's got a big battery in the bitch.
All right, now it's getting stronger.
Is it?
Yeah.
No, I just stop and I'm doing it every once in a while on you, so I didn't like you're holding it.
It's like it's pulsing. It's pulsing.
But Ian,
like a heartbeat.
He's probably so high he don't feel nothing.
Yeah, he's high.
That was
last
week.
Numb.
Watch his eyes. You can tell when I push the button. Watch.
Wait, now I'll close my eyes.
Gotcha.
Nah, it's not going. It's not going. I'll tell you, it's going. Going.
All right, let's test his
here,
ear
let's
loops.
Let's salt it. See, let's do your ear.
Yeah. Come on, let's do your ear.
Hey,
loops.
Salt. See if you.
Come on. Ready?
Wait.
Just your ear loop.
All right.
Ready?
It's crazy.
Salt is connecting.
Salt is supposed to be dead, right? Okay, go
salt
ahead.
Salt is connecting with like Ian's earlobe.
Hit it.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that he was pushing them together.
He connected it to Ian's earlobe and shocked the hell out of it.
That would hurt.
That would hurt.
Each nostril.
Grab it by your hand again, Salt. See if you could take it like Ian was.
Nah, I'm done with it.
Come on, man. You going to let this 19-year-old do you? Come on.
My heart skipped the beat. Mark said he wouldn't get shocked. Mark said he wouldn't get shocked. Let's try it.
I ain't getting shocked. I already been shocked. I got one. Remember me and Jeremy and them.
You want to give it a shot, Ron?
We used to put it on our neck.
Yeah, me neither. Fuck that.
Look, we used to put it on his our
ears,
neck.
His ear's red. Look.
Dude, it's, I can still feel a little bit.
Good Lord, it is fucking red.
Ow.
All right. So on Ian's desk today when I came in, I found a book called The Ultimate George W. Bushisms.
Yeah, what's that? Positions?
George Bushisms.
Yeah.
Now, these are just things that... Bush was a president.
Bushisms. I pushed in that Bushism many times.
Fuzzy math and all that kind of shit.
Bush was a president that had a lot to say. Not much was really said, but his fucking mouth opened and shit came out.
Did you ever see his YouTube quotes, his best quotes?
This is what we got right here. Bushisms. These are the best quotes from George W. Bush. This week's Bushism of the week is on being sick. One of my concerns is that healthcare cannot be as good as it can possibly be.
Elvis.
I said it right that time, didn't I? I was like Elvis.
Yeah.
Was that more of an Elvis?
Hey, what's up, Bob? Hey, what's up, Bob?
What you doing?
All right, well, let's try another one. This is one sicker. This is sick. That one was sick. This one's sicker. And so what General Petraeus is saying, some early signs, still dangerous, but give my chance a plan to work.
Hey,
give
this is chance John to Wayne, work. And I gotta take a shit.
Here's the number. Here's the number 25. Here's the number 25 Bushism of all time. If this were a dictatorship, it'd be a heck of a lot easier as long as I'm the dictator. Bush was a fucking dictator, wasn't he?
He was a dick.
His dick hole to his tank.
He was a dick and he ate taters.
All
right. He's a dictator. Man, I fuck so many taters. I'm allergic to them, though. They pop off me.
He got spuds. He got spuds from it.
He's got spuds. And it's dirty. This stuff's got junk on it. He didn't get his shit cut, and it rolls up dirt.
Got eyes
and
it gets on it.
Like a worm. When I pull the skin down, mud comes out. It's nasty.
Nasty.
Just like a worm, a big black worm.
Insert crickets here.
Yeah! And guess what?
I'm reading the Bushism.
All right, hit it.
Yeah, maybe it'd be funny if Salt like, read some Bushism.
Mike, sing a song while you're being shocked.
My job.
Make him sing next time, Albert.
I'm a decider.
Okay.
Let's see here. Seeing, Bush says.
Makes you hard?
Bush says to Peter Wallstein, Peter, are you going to ask the question with shades on? And Wallstein says, I can take them off. Bush says, I'm interested in the shade look. Seriously. Wallstein says, all right, I'll keep them on.
Man, this is like a movie back in the black and
Bush
white days.
Bush says, for the viewers, there's no sun. Wallstein says, I guess it depends on your perspective. And Bush says, touche.
Touche. He wants to fuck that guy.
Touché. He said touche.
Touche.
That was a blonde guy. The blind guy.
Tush. Mike is Archie Bunker.
Yeah, what?
We need to take away salt and relish and just call him Archie.
Archie.
Bunker.
Archie.
Hey, Archie. He's Archie Bunker. He can't and he also spell. Said, he can't pronounce words. He can't read. This fucking guy's dumb as shit.
Yes.
We'll call him Archie Bunker to fucking prejudice.
Well, mate, I do know that on May 7th, 2007.
And you smoke cigars with weed in it, you fucking blunt smoking fucker.
Queen Elizabeth, Washington, D.C.
You gotta tell me to quit my cussing.
Yeah, settle that cussing down over there, Squiddy Squid.
Sorry, Albert.
Blow me.
All right, that's all I have for.
All right, he ruined it.
I was gonna say.
Read on.
I was gonna say something about what he said to Queen Elizabeth. On May 7th, 2007.
He asked for some hand jerk
her
off.
He said to her that you helped our nation celebrate its bicentennial in 1976.
That's on every damn bicentennial quarter. You don't know that, you fucking dickhole?
He was going to say 1776.
I know. What a dumb.
Yeah, he was going to say 1776. But
she is that old, though. She's in pictures back then.
Man, you fucked that. As much as you spit on it, it still feels like fucking corn on the cob raw in that bitch. It's rubbing. It's like, damn,
with
who's ribbed?
Strap.
She's fucking ribbed. That sucks.
She's ribbed.
Get a reverse rubber, man. It motherfucking kick your ass.
Well, if nothing else, this segment has proven that comedy is not that easy.
It's very easy.
And
the
Bush's best quote, I think, is in New Orleans. He on January 12th, 2006, he said that New Orleans is a heck of a place to bring your family.
You know why? Because they got flooding around that motherfucker. That's why.
It's a heck of a place to bring your family and let them see the devastation.
And the drugs.
Right.
Come on down and leave your money at home because everything's free. People are looting.
And all the big dudes walk around and go like this. You gonna eat that cornbread? Give me that cornbread. And they take your fucking kids' food.
All right. Well, we got a serious artist in here today, folks. This is not just us trying to be funny here with my jackhole friends and serious executive producer.
Seriously.
We're here with Ronnie Giovanni from Florida. He just came up from Florida, folks. And he looks like he's going to be staying the summer and through the winter, which is the busier months for the musicians and the nightclubs and all that kind of stuff. So we're going to be out and about, and Ronnie will be out and about too. Ronnie, going to play a song here for us today? What do you got going?
One song is called Believe.
Believe? You wrote this song?
Yeah.
What's it all about?
It's just basically talking about my daughter and just wanting her to look up to me and, you know, kind of just respect her dad, basically.
How old's your daughter?
16.
16.
Wow.
16, like Ian's sister is going to be 16 on August 11th, is that
October.
Correct?
October.
I was gonna say, what?
October 11th, when we're going to do the urinalysis. On Ian. I make sure I put that on your... Make sure you write that note down. We're going to put that on the calendar.
Why are you waiting that long?
It's going to take 90 days.
It don't take 90 days.
That means if he pisses clean then, he stayed clean.
Generally, in 90 days, you're going to be clean.
Mike, what kind of interesting things did you do when you were high?
You ever stabbed anybody?
The producer?
Have you ever shot anyone? Have you ever robbed a fucking bank? Get the fuck out of here.
He was part of a conspiracy at Acme.
What? He broke them watermelons. You were that motherfucker that slammed the watermelons.
No, they were embezzling money.
No, it was a Griselda's Thriftway.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thriftway. I've heard about that.
13.
Oh man, congratulations! You were the best. You got all them lollipops and shit. Man, did you hit the cigarette store in there?
I never smoked a cigarette. Man,
you should have went there for the money. Fucking taking potted meat and shit. That's fucked up.
Spam.
I mean, steal something.
That's candy.
Oh, I didn't steal it.
Oh, that was easy.
No, what did you do?
He stole taco shells.
No, one of our managers did.
Oh, I heard it was some dude's sister.
That was that happened to be in Penn.
Remember they shot this kid?
Yeah, shopping center.
They shot this kid up there, man. It bled brains all over the place. some dude walked out. He says, "It looks like someone threw a hand grenade in a fucking deli." Is that the one? And there's dead people and blood all over this motherfucker.
Yeah, that was Ian. Brains.
Yeah, that's who he is. That was Ian. Your producer. Brains. Executive.
He got out of jail, and now he's our executive producer here.
Man, you ever jerk off in jail?
He still got to jail.
That water makes your dick red because of the rust.
I gotta get a beer. I thought that was when you got your red wings.
Yeah, that's when you got your red wings.
All right, so Ronnie's up from Florida, and he's going to be here for a while. And it looks like he brought his guitar. So possibly he's going to play a song for us tonight.
Sure.
Huh? Maybe a song or two?
Sure enough.
And now we have Ronnie Giovanni, who's going to play us a few original tunes. Take it away, Ronnie.
Another one. everything is gonna be alright. Hell no, now the show's out. In the sparkle in your eyes, I said, she's the one, she's the one. Man, she's got it all. She's the one, she's the one. Man, you were bound to fall. La 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 la.
So you think you got what it takes to rock the stage, mic, or radio? Give us a call at the Foul Mouth Al Show. We'll listen to what you got and direct you to the producers who can help, or we may just play your music straight on the air. Send your demo to foulmouthal@yahoo.com or call 302-423-0276. This is Ronnie Giovanni.
Don't forget to find me on Facebook. I have two pages, my personal Foulmouth Al page, which you're more than welcome to friend me, and our entertainer page. Please find that and like it. Look for the entertainer page. It's the one with the black and white logo. Please like me and tell your friends. Don't forget 5 for Foulmouth Al by Friday. In this section, Squid makes an attempt to record some lead-ins and public service announcements. Wait till you hear how this goes.
I'm surprised you ain't growing hair on that palm.
I got hair coming out of my dick, the rim and the top. It sucks in and breathes. It's weird.
It's like an egg in a nest.
Yep, it's like. This is Squiddy Squid. Don't miss the next Foul Mouth Owl show. This is Squiddy Squid telling you to join the FMA or Foul Mouth Army.
Yep.
This is Squiddy Squid telling you to join the Foul Mouth.
Start over.
Man, so you're going to have to write that.
For a few minutes. Let him finish this, or you're never going to get the lead.
You make me
I'm not letting
fucking diarrhea. It's hot wax coming out my ass.
No, uh-uh. Get out of here.
He's looking at stuff. He's going
to. I got inventory. Third one. Now he's gonna cry if you don't leave. You got
fuck out of here, fat boy.
Okay, come on, man. You wanna do this?
Nah, you're alright.
You gotta get it done. You ain't never gonna leave.
Wait till this is Squiddy
down.
Squid.
Wait till up and down the steps, because you'll hear all that stuff.
He's gonna look. This is Squiddy Squid telling you to join the Foulmouth Owl Army. All you gotta do is ask your favorite venue owner to host the next Foulmouth Owl show. It's great publicity. And we can even bring the entertainment. Give him our number, 302-423-0276. Or email us his information to foulmouth@yahoo.com.
Foulmouthal@yahoo.com.
Damn.
Read the whole thing.
This is Squiddy Squid telling you to join the Foulmouth Owl Army. All you got to do is ask your favorite venue owner to host the next Foulmouth Owl show. It's great publicity, and we can even bring the entertainment. Give him our number, 302-423-0276, or email us info to foulmouthowl@yahoo.com.
Stay up there.
What the fuck am I? I can't read!
I told you that.
All right. All right, I'll use that voice because I hate you. I'm walking home. Say you think what? Say you think you got what it takes to rock on stage, mic, and radio. Give us a call to the Foulmouth Owl Show. We'll listen to what you got, direct you to producers who can help. Do I gotta do it again?
So you think we
got what it takes to rock on the stage, mic and radio. Give us a call at the Foulmouth Owl Show. We'll listen to what you got, direct you to producers who can help, or we may just play the music straight on the air. Send your demo to foulmouthowl@yahoo.com or call 302-423-0276. This is Squiggity Squig. If you want to do a letter in school...
That's better.
I'm drunk, bitch. If you want to do better in school, there are three things all students must do. I'm... Foul mouth out.
No, I ain't. Do it now.
Squiggity squig.
Yeah, do it in the other voice like you did the last one. That was good.
Like what one? How did I do it?
You did like... So you think all you right. got one?
I'm doing... Check it out.
Yeah, Affleck.
Check it out.
Yeah, you could be the Gilbert Gild for of our show.
We're...
If you want to do better in school, there are three things all students must do. I'm Squiddity Squid with the Foul Mouth Owl student advisory message. Number one, always listen to the fucking teacher. Number two, always study for your test. Number three, spend the weekend whipping it in hell up with the Foul Mouth Owl Show.
Alright, you gotta read that again.
Why?
Number three is spend the weekend whipping it the hell up with the Foul Mouth Owl Show.
Number three, spend the weekend whipping it up in hell with the Foul...
Spend the weekend whipping it... Oh, shit. Whipping it the hell up. Take the N out.
Oh.
Sorry.
Number three, spend the weekend whipping it in hell up with... I'm a little verklempt. Remember the
Hold on.
Number three.
Number three. Spend the weekend whipping it in hell up with the F.
Spend the weekend whipping.
All right, let me read it regular. Whipping. Number three. Spend the weekend
scratch
whipping
the
in it.
Scratch the N
whipping
out.
It the hell up.
Man, you better scratch that
and
shit.
And he called me.
God, giggity goo.
He calls me Archie Bunker.
Yeah, I'm
my producer was on time.
Him.
We might have had that error correct.
You know what? That's what it is. If you want to
do better in school.
Alright.
If you want to do better in school, there are three things all good students must do. Squid skitty.
Squiddity squid.
Sam.
Yeah, I'll do this one.
I got it. Start all over?
Start
I'll get it right this time. Squiddity, squig, squiggly.
Squiddy squid.
Squiddy squid. Oh, that's nice.
Squiddy squid.
If you want to do better at school, there are three things all good students must do. I'm Squiddy Squid with a foul mouth student advisory message. Number one, always listen to the teacher. Number two, always study for your test. Number three, spend the weekend whipping it hell up with the Foul Mouth Owl Show. Subscribe on iTunes, bitches! Bitch!
Is that what you wanted, bitch?
You missed something up top.
Bizatch.
Bizatch. You didn't say owl.
I know. Man, are you that biggie?
Yeah, I can read it.
No, I'll be able to cut and paste. It's good in the next one.
You have got to see what the hell is going on the Foul Mouth Owl Show. Shock collar trivia, awesome new music, and they're about to travel to the different clubs, venues, and events. Watch for Foul Mouth Owl Show, soon to be in venue near you. This is Squiggity Squig, and I'm out of the closet.
He's out of the closet.
That's it.
Here, what about the other one?
There's a... What? There's no more.
There's a whole other page.
I'm done with that page. I need to get drunk.
This is Ronnie Giovanni telling you to join the Foul Mouth Owl Army. All you gotta do is ask your favorite venue owner to host the next Foul Mouth Owl Show. It's great publicity and we can even bring the entertainment. Give them our number, 302-423-0276, or email us information to foulmouthowl@yahoo.com.
In this final segment of our first episode, we discuss our jobs and the things that we need to do to have a great show and make some money. Ian's confidence has been down as he was recently devastated by a close female friend who he revealed his true inner feelings to, only to find that she does not feel the same way. Luckily, I have advice for Ian that everyone can use to improve their luck and confidence. Listen carefully as we reveal the things that we'll be doing in future shows, including speed dating, music events, and thinking outside of the box. Ian is in for a real education here as he learns marketing, sales, and production. He's definitely learning a lot about himself and the real world. We help guide him through with real-world advice and analyzation of a particular sales situation that Ian had been involved with. Don't forget to listen to our surefire way to improve your life and change your luck. Who needs to win friends and influence people when you have Facebook, YouTube, and the Foul Mouth Owl Show?
Chef Bones didn't show up. Don't know what happened to Chef Bones. Chef Bones has an awesome cookbook and array of art. And he'll be joining us at the Foul Mouth Owl Show. Ian, have you seen any of this television gizmo jazz going on with this Casey Anthony girl?
Yeah, after she got... after it was over, I seen all the Facebook statuses. Then I finally tuned in.
Yeah, everybody put a Facebook status with their fucked up opinion about that. Whoops, I said the F word. That's okay.
Yeah, I was living right there by Orlando.
Is that right?
That shit happened. Yeah, it's, man, it was 3 years of just, I mean, that's all you heard about. And then finally the trial, and then they took a news channel and televised the whole damn thing. Every day in court was televised.
Wait, it's been going for 3 years?
Well, she didn't go
to
court.
I swear to God, I recently... I thought it was just recent, like, and it was such a big case that they just started to...
Well, it was 3 years old, but, I mean, it took 3 years before she finally went to trial. Huh. Trial only lasted, what, like, they wrapped up in 14 days or something, but...
Well that was like the... she got found not guilty.
Yeah, that's... I mean... Anybody you talk to, the guys are like, oh, she's kind of hot. And the girls are like, she's the devil. Look at her. You can tell. And I'm like, whatever. It's either they were jealous or something.
The devil's hot, I guess.
She's
a
hot devil.
She's a hot devil, that's for sure. So she walked right out of there the other day.
At midnight.
Enjoy the rest of her life. Possibly get a book deal.
Sure.
And a movie. And then we'll find out her side of the story. For real. I mean, because everybody's kind of clobbering the girl, but nobody really knows what happened in that courtroom.
Hey, they ought to ship her to Delaware. Nobody knows where that place is at.
Yeah, right?
That's, I mean, nobody I can't really comment on it. I didn't follow the story too much.
Yeah, well, apparently she allegedly killed her kid, and they found her not guilty, and so she didn't kill her kid, but the whole world is outraged because she got out of jail, so...
Roy Kronk did it.
Who?
Roy Kronk.
Yeah, that guy.
He's a freak. Look at him.
I don't know him. Who is he?
He was the one that found the body.
Very possible.
He looks like a...
You were down there in that area at that time, weren't you, Ronnie?
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, I was right there.
Where were you that day that the baby died?
I wasn't in Orlando.
Yeah, I was in Daytona. Yeah, you just said you were. Now you're changing your story. That's kind of suspicious.
I was 50 miles away.
This thing's still lit up. Turn the shock collar off where somebody gets electrocuted here.
Just put it on each side of your ring. And
my ears still red?
Now your ears bit. Cleared up.
A little bit.
A little bit. Not too bad. That shit was awesome.
That was
so
cool.
So,
that
hurt. You into sports at all, Ian?
Yeah, I love sports. I played baseball in high school.
Did you?
Yeah, I played baseball since I was 5, to be honest, actually. I like watching football. I get into basketball, like, during the playoffs. Actually, when it comes to football, I'm more of an Eagles fan than a football fan. But I still, like, watch it. I love watching the highlights. Hockey, I never got into hockey. I can watch, like, the YouTube hits.
Now, that's a sport that I actually went to. I used to go to hockey games all the time.
Really?
As a kid growing up in the Baltimore Civic Center, a friend of mine worked there, so we had free tickets. So every home hockey game, we were there. I still got pucks that are signed and shit. So, but most of the sports I'm really not into. So some of the stuff we're going to be doing in the future won't have nothing to do with sports. So... But on the subject of sports, how about them fucking Japs beating the U.S. in soccer?
After the tsunami, all that stuff happened over there, I thought that was pretty cool.
After the tsunami?
Yeah, you know what I mean? I think, of course I would want U.S. to win.
What are you saying? You like Japanese people because of the tsunami?
No, I'm just saying I think they deserved that a little bit.
I was born in Japan.
Right.
So you're a Jap.
I'm an army brat.
Yeah, but so what? They had a tsunami.
I just think it's good. You know what I mean? I don't like soccer.
You think it's good that they had a tsunami?
No, I like it's no. Said. I think it's good that they
won. Can
you
quote him on that?
Yeah, I got it on tape.
It's good for their country that day.
Look, Japanese people are like 4 feet tall, and they got legs the size of, they're like these little teeny legs. How do these guys beat us in soccer?
I don't know.
What happened?
Good shoes.
Do I have to start paying attention to sports? What the hell's going on over there?
That was anyway. The second time the U.S. has been in there, supposedly, in, what, like 12 years or something that they've been in that World Cup?
All I know is Japanese beat us at soccer. I'd rather them beat us at soccer than at war anyway, so, but... Anyway, that's Foul Mouth Allen Sports. We don't do sports here, so I had to bring up... I saw it on TV the other day. It made me fucking sick. Japanese beat us at soccer. That's crazy. So...
We could send Casey Anthony to Japan.
She probably is going to go over there. She's probably huge in Japan. They eat babies over there. She could have sold her baby and let it sit in a pond for 3 weeks, and then it would have been a delicacy.
Yeah, right. All bloated.
That's one of the things that Foul Mouth Al might say that people might not like too much. But this is a free speech format, and I'm a little bit sick and twisted sometimes. So
they said she drowned, so who knows?
So, Ian, what are we going to do here, man? We need venues, entertainers. We need characters for this show. We need a Facebook page that gets pumped up. I mean, I started something. I have an entertainer, my Foul Mouth Al Facebook page. I have that. So you can friend me as Foul Mouth Al. But I also have an entertainer page for Foul Mouth Al, which is where the show is going to be located. I'm sure I'll have links on all the other pages that we all have to link to that. What else are we going to do? Where are we going to vent? Where are we going to? You got any ideas on some venues or events coming up? Music vents? What do you got? You're the producer here.
I don't know why you would give me that job. I don't know. I can't even think of any events coming up. I can think of maybe some places holding an event.
What, you don't want the job?
I don't know. I don't know, man. I really don't know. I think I'll be good at reading stuff. I think I'll be good at... I don't know. I didn't show too much on Dungeon of Man Love, but depending on what I would be reading, as far as, like, getting gigs, I can definitely do stuff like that. You know what I mean? Like, I know a lot of people that are trying to do stuff with music. I don't know where to go from there, though.
You find entertainers, you mean?
Yeah. And I feel like I just have... I feel like, to be honest, the way I... If this falls under producing, I feel like I have a good opinion on who would go where. You know what I mean? Where they would fit.
Yeah, but there's no career in that, so...
I know, I would love to be... got that.
We got to make phone calls and get venues to work with us. We got to get entertainers to show up. Book the schedule up, you know, a few months in advance, you know, get some people. We know next week we got people coming in the week after that. We'll have people coming in. We know who it is, what segment they're, what time they're going to come in.
I don't know how well I'm going to do with, like, I don't know, making phone calls. It's kind of off topic, but.
The bottom line is you don't know if you're going to be able to get out of bed tomorrow morning. Don't matter. What matters is what do we need to do?
Yeah.
And you make that. We're gonna talk about that. We're going to do that stuff. And then we're going to do it. Mm-hmm. And we're going to make something happen, and you're going to fuck up and make money.
Hopefully.
No, you're going to fuck... There's no way... How can you not make money?
Saying hopefully we make some money. Like,
no, we will make some money. I guarantee you we'll make some money. Money comes if you do the right things. We're going to sit down, and we're going to figure out exactly what we will need to do as far as phone calls and get in front of the right people, and I guarantee you're going to make money.
Like I said, man, I know... I'm not sure what I want to do yet. Like, are you going to edit... Is this on?
Yeah, we're recording right now.
All
right.
Well, I said I'm not sure really what I want to do yet, but I just know that, you know, I mean, this stuff just feels right. I'm in the right direction, whether it's...
Well, on this show here, we're going to use you as the executive producer.
Okay.
All right.
And so, try me out there. You know what I mean? We'll see how it goes.
What's that?
I said we'll try that out on me. You know what I mean? I'll see how I do.
I'm going to show you what you need to do, tell you what you need to do, and then you're going to do it. And that it'll work. We don't know how it's going to happen. It's just going to happen. Mm-hmm. It happens when you think about stuff and you figure out what you got to do to get something done, and then you take those steps, those actions, and then stuff gets done. It's called get her done. It's what we call get her done down here below the canal. I know you're from up north there where this is slower, lower Delaware.
Yeah.
We get her done. We will get her done. Right, Ronnie?
Maybe not in those exact terms, but...
Ronnie's from way below the canal. He keeps going till he hits the fucking end of the country.
Get her done!
Yeah, that's right.
Larry the Cable Guy. He came from Orlando. He don't even talk like that. You know that?
Really?
He has a regular voice.
Yeah, he don't talk like that.
He don't.
I guess.
No, he's not really. He's not really redneck.
So, we've got shot collar trivia. We got live entertainment. We've got hypnosis, mentalism, and speed dating that are options for things that we can do right now. We can add some other stuff to that mix.
What's mentalism?
Mentalism is where it's kind of like where you're psychic to some degree.
Ghosts are probably... Is that the person you're...
No.
Think of something and somebody can, like, basically...
There's a guy that we know. His name's Marshall Manlove. He is a full-time licensed or full-time hypnotist and mentalist. That is what Marshall does for a living. That's his profession. So, I've never seen his hypnotism.
I knew he did hypnotism.
You did what?
I knew he did the hypnotism. I didn't know he did all the mental... I didn't know he knew about
You gotta pay attention to the people you're working with, man. Yeah. It's important. That's a big opportunity. You could be booking gigs for him, $2,500 a shot. You know, 10% is all he pays you, but you know, those are. Outside of you gotta open your eyes.
I've seen his shows. I've
you gotta open your eyes, look around, and the walls. That's the box. You gotta get out of that box, and you gotta think outside of the box. That's what we're gonna teach you to do.
I know. Like, this is kind of off topic, but when I was passing those flyers out today, it was something new to me. Like, I was driving around for a while, and, like I'll be straight up, like, if there were, like, five cars in a parking lot or at this one, it was intimidating seeing a lot of cars outside because I just felt like I couldn't just go in and march up right to the guy in charge to give the flyer to while customers, you know what I mean? So I kind of, like, I only went to three places, two that I already knew, so it was kind of easy. And one, I went to a produce place that's been around for a little bit, and it's run by, they're from, like, India, I think. And that didn't even go too well. I was the only one in there. But I kind of choked up. A customer was walking up to the door, and I just kind of choked up a little bit. I didn't want to be, you know what I mean, hold them up too much. I just feel like I don't want to feel like I'm intruding. You know what I mean? So,
yep.
But it was new to me a little bit. You know what I mean? But I...
Well, we'll go out together a couple times, and I'll show you. There's a time where you need to be assertive and... be in front of that customer and take your time and your turn without taking up too much time because you know somebody's waiting.
You know, I'll be honest, I didn't even go in a collared shirt.
What are we trying to do when we go out and we pass out those flyers? What's the point of that?
To get them to set an appointment? What do you mean, to make money? I don't know.
The goal of passing out the flyers is two things. If you get the right person, you need to create interest and you got to get their information. You always got to get there. Who do I need to talk to? Who's the person that makes the decisions? Manager, owner? What's their name? And get their phone number so you can call them back.
Yeah, like I said, it was kind of easy for me because today I dropped one off where I work, and then I dropped another one off to my mom. It's a high school with the. It's a couple. They own a shop, but I haven't even seen her. I mostly know the woman. I haven't seen her in years. Like. Probably since I was a little guy, you know what I mean. I always drive by their shop all the time, and I just was like, you know what I mean, stop in. Plus, she was homecoming queen in high school. I just wanted to check up on her, see how she was. I've seen pictures of her in high. You know what I mean?
So right.
Well, but it was easy for me to go in. You know what I mean? It was kind
of
easy to.
And that's fine, especially on your first handful of these. You should try to make it easy as you could. And like I told you though, when you're out doing this. You're going to learn a lot about yourself because you're going to find when you are intimidated, you know, you're going to ask yourself these questions. Why, you know, what the hell's wrong with me? Why don't I want to walk in there right now?
Yeah. I don't know.
You'll figure those things out.
This is one thing I always think about. I was at a tattoo parlor with a buddy of mine. He was getting a tattoo done. And there's two guys. One is the owner of the shop. He was like drawing up a tattoo at the time. And there was a guy, I guess it's the guy who's one of his apprentices, you know what I mean? Another guy that does tattoos too, where they were both sitting at the desk and a guy walked in and I don't know what he was like. I don't know if he was doing, it was something like how I would walk in and present something. And he was like, is the owner here? And the guy, like the owner didn't say anything. And the other guy was just like, nah, man, we're not, the owner's not here. We're not looking for any kind of, it was just kind of, and you could see in the guy's face that he was, you know what I mean? That just, I don't know if it makes sense to you, but.
He was done.
Yeah, he was pretty much shot down right there. Yeah. And the owner was sitting
why
right...
Why do you think he was shot down?
Because
What do you think he did wrong?
When he walked in, he said his name, I'm so-and-so, I'm with whatever, and they just shot him down because they weren't interested. You know what I mean? It's just that...
What was he selling? What was he doing?
I don't know. I couldn't tell you that. I know he was... I can't remember this. I know he was like I said, it was a little shopping center, wall to wall, so he was going to each one.
So what did he do wrong?
I don't know. What I can remember is the guy that talked for the owner said, I know your job's hard, bud, but sorry, we're not interested at all. But he pretty much shot him down, like, I don't even know, like, before he could even really get all the way out. So I think he got his name out and then said who he's with and what he's about. And then before he started, he was asking if the owner was there, and he was like, no, the owner's not here, but we're not interested, pretty much.
What was he trying to sell?
Here's my point.
Yeah.
The guy came in. He didn't make much of an impact. Mm-hmm. He had no clue what he was doing. He could have been giving away money.
Yeah. But then also, I got a kind of feeling like... I don't want to judge people, but like the one guy was trying to be more of a cool guy just to show off in front of me and my friends to be like, yeah, we don't want nothing to do with this guy. You know what I mean? He was like, the owner's not here, but.
And that's fine. You know what's going to happen? If you go out and you pass out 100 flyers, you're going to see 20 of those dicks.
It was an older guy. Like, he could at least listen to what he had to say. Well, like, they weren't doing anything.
The bottom line is, you know, you're going to run across that, and it's all about this. Let's say we walk into that shop and they were that way with us. No problem. We walk out. We go to the next guy. We don't need them. We need these other guys that are interested. Out of 100 people, there's going to be 7 or 8 that are going to be... There's going to be 10 interested. There's going to be 4 or 5 that we can actually talk to. And there's going to be 2 or 3 that we're going to get appointments with and we're going to actually make sales with. Yeah. So there's a lot of out there. And those ones that make you feel weird and you have to learn that they don't matter. And when you take that power away from them, then it don't matter. No problem, dude. You have a good day. Because his attitude is going to fuck up his day and his life and let him have it and go on. You don't want to be there. You're in the wrong place then. You go on to the next guy. That's all sales is. It's a numbers game. Now, a whole nother situation, okay? There's a hot chick standing next to that kid. Does he want to seem like a jerk now to some old guy that's in there just trying to make an honest living?
Probably not.
So that guy walked in at a bad time. Mm-hmm. Okay? So if we want to put it on the guy at the tattoo shop, then that guy just walked in at the bad time. If you want to put it on the sales guy, what could the sales guy do different? He could have came in and said, bam! How's everybody doing today?
Yeah.
That would get people and throw them off guard. And sometimes if people are a little stuffy...
Yeah.
I did some outrageous shit in people's house on their turf. And couldn't believe that it threw off everything that was going against me and actually helped me close the sales. So I had people run their vacuum cleaner that they use. When I sold vacuums for 15 years.
Yeah.
I had a guy so excited, and he hated his vacuum so much, they wanted to beat it. They wanted to just beat it over with a tree. And so I said, I'll give you an extra $50 for it on your trade-in if you'll let the kids run it over with the car. And they were like, get the keys! Boom! And so you just do something crazy like that, and it turns things around, you know?
Mm-hmm.
That wasn't a good example because they were pretty much buying anyway.
I mean, I just got to get... It was all new to me, you know what I mean? I kind of got to get
it
out
is,
of that.
It is. The key thing is... You know, if you go to a bar, it's like I said, and you want to get laid, and you ask 100 girls, 99 of them are going to slap you, turn you down at minimum, might call the bouncer on you. But there's going to be one that's going to say, let's hit the car.
Yeah.
None of them 99 counted. They don't count. How you doing? Want to hit the car? I'll buy you a drink. No? Fantastic. You have a great day. It's all about you and your attitude.
That's it.
That's what it's all about. So
you got to believe in what you're... doing.
Here's the first thing that's got to happen. You got to pay real close attention. You got to show up on time. It's important. Because we have a limited time to work on this stuff. You got other shit to do. I got other shit to do. And we're doing this for free right now. So we better get it organized, do it properly, do that consistently, and other people will jump on board. So I stopped at Wolfie's Bar
today here in Smyrna, Delaware, and they seem pretty receptive. I'm going to be talking to the guy on Friday. I'm going to be talking to the young lady at JW's Lounge in Dover, Delaware, on Wednesday about setting up a remote from there. So I have two people, two remotes. Maybe we can do something with one of them. So this is Foul Mouth. Check us out at foulmouthal.com. If you haven't been there yet, don't know how you can't be there if you're listening to this. Look for us on iTunes and subscribe there. The Foul Mouth Al Show is there. You can subscribe to it. It downloads automatically to your computer. That was the air conditioner kicking off, if you heard that. Send us an email, foulmouthal@yahoo.com. If you're a band and you like to get on the show, give me a call, 302-423-0276. Please look for us on Facebook. And now for my outro. I'm going to try to read this here. Just so you'll know that the Foul Mouth Al will always be hosted by yours truly, Foul Mouth Al. The show will air weekly at foulmouthal.com or find us easily and subscribe on iTunes. I'm now going to instruct you on what you, the listener, needs to do for the Foul Mouth Al Show. I mean, after all, ask not what the Foul Mouth Al Show can do for you. Ask what you can do for the Foul Mouth Al Show. Listen very carefully. This information is vital. When you find yourself in conversation and you discover the thought, that sound, or the thing, whatever it is that reminds you of the Foul Mouth Al Show, you'll need to be prepared. This next few minutes will give you all the tools that you need to speak with intelligence when you're subconsciously plugging the Foul Mouth Al Show to your friends. Now relax, take a deep breath. Let it out slowly. Imagine yourself floating along the highway and you see yourself about to tell someone about the Foul Mouth Al Show. They're thinking it's a potty mouth show. We must let them know that the Foul Mouth Al Show is a celebration of arts and the music scene that's here on the East Coast. Now, the most important points that really need to be stressed are as follows. The Foul Mouth Al Show has a great cast of people, fun-loving, hard-working, honest individuals who bring in only the best talent, will work hard for our sponsors and advertisers, and from time to time may actually say or do something interesting or funny. We plan on working hard to bring you the best information on music, the arts, and the events that showcase them, and the things that our supporters do to make your life easier and more comfortable. The important thing here is that you subscribe. When you're talking about this show to your friends, they need to understand. All they have to do is subscribe and tell five friends to subscribe. And they need to know that when they find their five friends, they need to tell those five friends that they need to tell five friends, who will tell another five, and so on. And we're going to call it Five for Foul Mouth Al by Friday. That's 3 S. Five for Foul Mouth Al by Friday. This is your goal. Remember, you got to tell five people for Foul Mouth Al by Friday. This is done properly, with positive enthusiasm. Luck will come your way, Ian. And I'm not joking. Try it and you'll see. If you're tired of luck being against you, you've been in a rut, haven't you?
Yeah.
You've lost your confidence, haven't you?
Yeah.
You don't know where to go. You're here. You were here at a meeting yesterday. You didn't even know to show up today. You've lost your way, son. And Foul Mouth Al is going to help get your shit together. I'm here to help you, man. I'm here to help you. I'm not joking. If you're tired of the luck being against you, all you got to do is do something different than what you were doing before. Change something. Change things up. That's all it takes. One thing different and your whole day, week, life, for that matter, is changed. Try it. What do you got to lose besides good luck, happiness, and fortune for the rest of your life? For the Foul Mouth Al Show, this is Foul Mouth Al signing off.
This is Ronnie Giovanni. Don't miss the next Foul Mouth Al Show.